Canada's up here, according to the United Nations Human Development Index, quality of life, up high. Apply the same indices to First Nations people, we're 63rd. This is the gap that needs to be closed. And so we need investments in housing and water and education and deal with mental health issues, because our youth suicide rate is 5 to 7 times the national average. We've got 40,000 First Nations children in foster care. We got too many of our people in jail. So this gap is not good for us as First Nations people, and it's not good for Canada. So once we start closing this gap, it's good for our people, but ultimately it's good for the country as a whole. So that's going to be the agenda going forward. Second piece. We've heard that our Assembly of First Nations Charter needs to be reviewed. And so we're going to work with our AFN executive, we're going to work with our Chiefs and Assembly and outline that plan going forward. The AFN Charter has not been amended in many, many years. So that's going to be another priority we go on going forward. So we're going to look at closing the gap, working with not only federal governments but provincial governments in order to do that. And as well look at how can we make our Assembly of First Nations better, more effective. It's an advocacy organization. And so we want to make sure that our Assembly of First Nation is relevant to First Nations people, that it's responsive to the issues and concerns identified, and that it's respectful of the diversity. And that's the plan going to go forward. I think we're driving the agenda, and they're finally responding to our agenda in a positive way, finally. And that's the most important thing to put in mind, is that we're driving the agenda based on our chief's direction. That we get in assembly, and by our AFN executive, that we get by motions from our AFN executive team. So they're finally responding in a positive way to what we're putting forward. And I think that's a positive thing, because you're bringing about policy and legislative change, and you're starting to see investments in education and water and housing and healthcare, and commitments to really do something very vital to our survival as Indigenous peoples, is that bring about that Indigenous Languages Revitalization Act. So they're responding to our agenda that we're putting in front of them. And so that's the way I would couch it.